doppio registro del titolo della nuova mostra che mette insieme due talenti del fotogiornalismo, il materano Gaetano Plasmati e il bengalese GMB Akash, quest'ultimo già insignito del prestigioso World Press Photo, visitabile a Matera nella galleria di Porta Pepice in via delle Beccherie 55. Working class o working clash perché c'è una classe che lavora ma che al contempo nel mondo col lavoro si scontra e a rimetterci è la dignità del lavoratore. Nei 50 scatti esposti, frutto di un lavoro svolto nel mondo intero da entrambi a cavallo degli ultimi 15 anni, Plasmati e Akash si avventurano proprio nei viaggi attraverso la dignità, come recita il sottotitolo, di chi vivendo in condizioni di guerra o povertà ha ormai rinunciato per sempre all'affermazione dei propri diritti, abdicando a favore di un'esistenza in bilico. Si tratta di scorci o più brutalmente di squarci aperti su mondi fatti di solitudine e spesso di umiliazione, ma animati da una tenacia sorprendente che sono soltanto apparentemente lontani da noi, perché il nord e il sud del globo, il suo est e il suo ovest in questo caso, finiscono tristemente col combaciare, visto che i diritti umani stanno scolorendo un po' ovunque, che sia nella Cina o nell'India che si stanno affermando, o nell'Europa che va verso il declino, uccisa dalla cultura consumistica che essa stessa ha alimentato. Una riflessione in immagini curata da Maristella Trombetta, docente di estetica e storia della critica d'arte presso l'Università degli Studi di Bari, che senza cercare il sensazionalismo colpiscono cuore e mente allo stesso momento e inducono ad una sola domanda: dove stiamo andando? La quale richiederebbe una risposta dai governi che muovono il mondo, che puntualmente tarda ad arrivare, fagocitando bambini sfruttati tra i più deboli e giovani in costante mobilità alla ricerca di un futuro migliore, anche nei cosiddetti paesi civili. Ancora un prestigioso tassello culturale tra gli eventi materani, seppur ignorato dall'establishment istituzionale e nel curriculum di due fotografi straordinari che, pur vivendo agli antipodi sul piano geografico, riescono a condividere fraternamente una missione: raccontare la verità attraverso i propri occhi, sempre e comunque.
Nella galleria Porta Pepice a Matera torna il nome di Gaetano Plasmati, torna il nome di Akash, ancora una volta insieme, questa volta per una indagine fotografica sul mondo del lavoro, inteso come mondo globale, diciamo così. Spesso si dice, o meglio, il detto dice che il lavoro nobilita l'uomo, in questo caso forse si sottolinea anche che spesso gli toglie dignità quando c'è e quando non c'è.
Sì, in questo lungo lavoro è proprio questo che abbiamo cercato, questo della ricerca della dignità del lavoro. Un lavoro lungo fra Asia e Europa dove c'è piano piano questa perdita di lavoro. Dagli anni Ottanta l'economia cambia, c'è alcune aziende che delocalizzano il lavoro, un po' perdita di valori, anche di potere di sindacati, quello di investimenti anche in alcuni paesi dell'Asia. E questo ha fatto sì che pian piano l'Europa ha cambiato un po' la sua economia, il mondo del lavoro è cambiato e c'è questa crisi, non solo di lavoro ma anche di organizzazione del lavoro, anche di valori, questo continuo consumismo forse che si sta... che è avvenuto negli scorsi anni, abbiamo capito che è cambiato qualcosa si è rotto, quindi va trovata anche una soluzione. Abbiamo bisogno di dati, abbiamo bisogno di soluzioni, abbiamo bisogno di capire che cosa dobbiamo fare, che cosa devono fare i ragazzi nelle scelte del lavoro.
It's about, you know, now there is a huge problem is going on everywhere in the world. The crisis of work, crisis of economy. You know, people are moving, they're leaving their country, leaving their family for a better life. Even a lot of factories, they're working, you know, factories also moving. They're moving from Europe to Bangladesh or poor countries for the cheap labor. So people working there with very cheap price, very little money. They have no safety. They're working 10 hours to 20 hours inside very poor condition. the situation is improving, but it's still a lot of people working in very hard situation, very little light, long time with very little money, and a lot of European companies, they are producing their everything, like you wearing t-shirt, maybe it's made in Bangladesh, and everything maybe you are wearing is from Bangladesh or Vietnam, because the labor is very cheap there. And then this factory go there, and then you have also problem in Europe, that you don't have any more work. People are, you know, people a lot of people are without work here. I see a lot of people, they look very sad, even they have everything. And I don't see, if you go to Bangladesh, you'll see a lot of energy. People are working everywhere. Even they have nothing, they're very strong. You know, a lot of energy is there. But if I go, come to Europe in the same time, I see a lot of people are very alone, single, and looks very depressed. And I see in Bangladesh, a lot of people are working everywhere. Here, I don't see people are working. Maybe they have shop, just sitting there. And the business is not anymore here. It's all the factories are going to poor countries because the labor is cheap. And this is the exhibition we are working for a long time together. We also did 2 years ago, we did another project about the environment and the climate change, the flood, the natural disaster. And we worked for a long time and it was not easy. Also this one is more difficult because these factories, they don't allow you to go inside, all inside. So you need really give a lot of time to get into these factories. And then you talk to them and you really see the situation out there. And they work with very little price. They even don't know, you know, how much this t-shirt is selling in Europe. And so it's a whole, it's not only Bangladesh, it's affecting also the people who are living in Europe, especially in the South Europe, like Italy, Greece, Portugal.
La Grecia, l'Italia meridionale, il Portogallo, molta gente sta andando via, molti ragazzi che hanno un'istruzione stanno andando via e non si sta dando una soluzione. Questo è quello che oggi unisce questa mostra, una soluzione, una ricerca fra Asia e Europa che non sono così lontane ma che hanno una connessione.
This is a very important exhibition for us because, you know, as a photographer, what we feel, we are eyes of other people. No, everybody cannot go these places. The people have different life. People are, they're students, they're doing business. They don't travel like a photographer. So as a photographer, this is our responsibility to show what is happening around the world. Otherwise, a lot of people, they will never know. And photographers are different because they go really close. They do themselves. They expend time. They expend money from their pocket. Yeah, and it makes making this whole project, it takes a lot of money and time. Not you just go there and click. You have to travel. We travel many countries, and it took long time to go access the factories, and producing this exhibition is also expensive. It needs a lot of money. But why we are doing it? Because we feel this is our responsibility as artists, as a journalist, to show what happening. Otherwise, people will never. Know about it. You know what I believe, you can make a living what you get, but you can make a life by what you give. So we are trying to show these things to making lives, you know, putting people have, otherwise people don't have idea. So people know the situation, and a lot of you never know if you can change one people's mind or soul. That's also huge things. You never know, maybe somebody will come forward and do something. Otherwise, people will know this story. So we feel this is our responsibility to have this exhibition. And we are planning to take this exhibition also in Bangladesh, so other part, not only Europe. So Bangladesh people can also see this exhibition. even this picture, the people, they don't know what is happening with their images. But we are not, I'm not only a photographer, I'm also a human being. And I really wanted to make changes, not only through my images, but also I wanted to do something for them. So we started First Light Institute of Photography, a photography school, and we organized workshop and also one-to-one workshop for students from abroad. The students are coming from all around the world, also for Bangladeshi students. We are going to organize a workshop in India. I just took workshop in Siena, Italy, also in Switzerland. So all the money we earn from this school is go to support these children, working children. We have a school where we teach 60 children. We give them education free. We also set 24 business for 24 family. We talk to them and try to understand what kind of business they're able to do. We start the business, we survey the market, and we give this business as a gift. Gift, no credit. So they can generate their income. So they don't need to, they can generate their income slowly. So they don't need to send their children to work. They can send them to factory, to the school. The main problem of this family, they're poor, they cannot afford. You know, they have to work, and all, whole family member, they work. We also do a lot of different kind of activities from this school. So we set up this school, and whatever we earn from the school, all the single money goes for doing something for the people, something the people I'm working with. So we have many different activities. So teaching children, giving business to the family. Sometimes we go to the station and collect street boys. And some of these street boys, they even don't take shower for 15 days or 20 days. We give them shower, cut them nail, cut their hair, buy new dresses for them, and take to them to a restaurant for eating good, because they don't eat in a good restaurant, they have no opportunities. Then we also explain with them time to give them basic education. And we try to also find children from this group who are really want to change their life. They don't want to live in their station or on the street. And so we spend more time with them. We go often, so often, and we give them sometimes business. So they are businessmen. We try to make them businessmen rather than, you know, street boys. So they have more dignity. So we have a lot of, like recently we distribute 500 toys to 500 working children, because these children don't have chance to buy toys. So we thought it will be wonderful, because for children, toys is very important. It doesn't matter what you give, if you give them a simple toys, they will be really happy. So you go factories and distribute 500 toys to 500 children, and it was amazing. He's like my brother. We live in a different part. I feel, you know, 50% Italian in my inside, because I really like the life, the people in Italian. They are like Bangladeshi, always smiling, shouting, touching each other, making fun. And Gaetano is always, for me, is a 50% Bangladeshi person. And we have a long-time friendship, understanding. You know, you really have to be a good relationship if you really continue this kind of project. You have to talk, you have to discuss your idea, you have to share knowledges, and you have to really trust each other. So, and Gaetano is a wonderful person. He is like my mentor, my friend, my brother, my family. And we always sharing, you know, we live a far distance from each other. Every single day we are talking in Facebook or through social network. And these ideas take a long time to give a shape, you know. You have to talk for a long time, you have to talk, discuss what we'll do, how we will present, how can we will change people's mind or educate people or just show them what we see. This is not only photographs, this is our experiences. We are here to share our experiences, not only photographs.